show you how to put a hem on a rounded piece. This is a chair pad cover. There's the front, and I am working on the back right now. What I've done is I have trimmed it to about 2 inches. I think my serger took off a little more in some places, about 1 3/4 inches, somewhere around there. You don't have to serge the edges. I just find it handy when you're working with the monk's cloth that frays a lot. You can also zigzag it, and you can also not do anything at all. So what you want to do is you want to do a basting stitch. First, I've just tacked the thread in place just to secure it. You can try knotting it, but knotting through monk's cloth with the big holes is kind of a really huge knot. And basting stitch is really just big stitches. I'm taking about 1/4 inch stitches and use the whole length of that needle. I'm using just a heavy machine twist. You can double up a thread, something that you can pull on that you don't have to worry about it breaking. I'm just going to do a bunch here and just do a little section so you have an idea of how this is going to work. And just keep following that around. I think this will be the last section here. There's another thread in here. I was going to do it in white and realized it wasn't going to show up. So I'm actually going to bring the needle to the front, so that'll make it easier for pulling it. And to give you an idea here, so you want to lay it back down. You're going to want to tuck that so it meets the hooking. And then you can see that you can kind of ease all of that fabric with the basting stitches, if I can get my hands out of the way. And then the easiest thing to do, give it a little steam press. And there, it's relatively flat. There are a few little bumps here and there. I actually do go ahead and pin it in place. I find it easier when I'm doing my stitching, final stitching. But I would certainly go ahead and do the entire circle. And then you're going to come back and whip stitch this edge down through to the monk's cloth and up through this monk's cloth. There you go, hemming a circle.